good morning. It is the first day of lockdown. Good morning. It is the last day before lockdown. And I'm really trying to seize every moment. So I'm gonna go to Go Ape today, which is like a treetop adventure. But it's really cold outside. It's actually the first day that I've seen the frost. Can you see? The grass is like white. I'm trying to have a good frame of mind before we get into this lockdown. It's been a bit of a hectic morning. I am here waiting for my friend. The thing is, I have no idea if I'm in the right place. I should probably get out and check, but we're supposed to start at 10 for Go Ape. And the thing is, no one's here and it's 9:58. So I'm a bit confused. That supposedly is where it is. I hate being late for things. It's literally my worst nightmare. Okay, is that car following? I even don't know if I'm parked in the right place. I'm really panicking.
What are you doing?
I am climbing.
We are sweating out. Oh, look at my hand shaking.
Are you scared?
No, it's...
Wow, look at this wonder. Mum coming through.
Hello.
Yet again, here we are. I thought, seeing as last time there was lockdown, you guys seem to really enjoy the vlogs. This morning, I need to plan what my videos are gonna look like, because obviously I've been doing a lot of home content. Since March, I've been doing home content. And it gets a bit tricky because you run out of ideas, but I've still been trying to think creatively and trying to do videos that are not the same. Have a little think and try and plan out from now until December, because in December what I'm thinking of doing, right, is Vlogmas but with a little bit of a change. So I was gonna do vlogging every other day, because I don't know if there's enough. My life's not that exciting if you haven't established already. But also, I was gonna do it with a bit of a change in that every day I wanted to do something new, so that A, you could try at home to maybe put a bit of change in your day, or B, so that it makes them a bit more exciting, and C, that you can, it makes me a bit more exciting really. So I'm planning out what I can do each day that's different. But I really do feel so weird today. I can't place my finger on the emotion. It's like an emotion that I haven't really felt before. I think I just keep trying to compare myself, when obviously we all know that comparison is the thief of all joy.
Whoa! What are you doing, you road hogger? Oh my gosh, she literally just like swerved into the road. You absolute road hogger.
The clothes in Asda are kind of popping off. This jumper is nice, isn't it? That's lovely. Little black fur number. Fighting every urge to buy that black fur coat. Also just checking Christmas pajamas on the horizon. Store it out. It is the emptiest that I have ever seen Asda, which is really reassuring actually.
Flipping cute, and these little reindeer crumpets. So cute.
Okay, so went to Asda. My camera is so broken. Trailer tape is holding it together. And it was so empty, which I'm very happy about. And got all my bits and bobs, been on a run, although it wasn't very good. I think I'm overrunning. Maybe not, I don't know. This girl looks so exhausted. Oh. You're so cute, Banksy. Oh, look how fluffy your chest is. You look like a flipping lion. Oh, licky lick, yeah. And now I'm gonna go and do the bathroom, because the bathroom needs a big, fat, juicy clean. Also, look at this. I've never seen these before. Trifle sponges, what even are you? I wanna eat one, I wanna try.
Can you put my wife's gonna lay the table soon?
Yes, I can, Mum.
Thanks, yeah.
Not a problem. Oh no, I forgot to put the parsley in the fridge. Can we for a minute just talk about how fantastic marigolds are? Like, they just protect your hands from getting ruined. I think that is one of the most genius inventions. I think that marigolds don't get the time of day that they deserve. I just think they're so amazing. Aren't they good? Anyway, I'm gonna clean the bathroom now. Roast? Thursday?
Well, it's not really roast.
Then what's that advert? You know the one? Where she goes like, she's lying in the bed, she goes, roast on a Thursday.
Oh yeah.
You know the
this
one?
Is some chicken.
Hi, Bangs! Hi! Oh, do you think it's your dinner time too? You've always got kibble there. You've got the kibble there all the time.
It's firework night. Oh, as I pull the camera out, they all stop. Come on, let's crack a firework.
We had a great bonfire night last year, didn't we? We had loads of people around. What did we eat? Pizza. Oh well. Next year we can hope, right? Anyway, I think it's time for advent calendar reveal. I almost don't want to tell you whose advent calendar is whose, and then you just take the one you want, but that could end an argument, because I know.
Could end a fight.
Fight. Oh my gosh, it was a two!
Oh, they're pretty.
There was a two in the sky over there.
The thing is, there are lots of different advent calendars. Like, there was ones that I saw that I've had over the years. Like, I've had the Pringles one, I've had the Millions one, we've done the Haribo, we've done all sorts, honestly. But then there are also cool ones, like Hammer Beads, which are like crafty ones. There's this one I saw in Duluth, which was so bougie, which was like a little craft kit. And a chocolate, and it was vegan, like sustainable, but that was £60, and I'd already bought them all by now. And I think more are starting to come out. But I think over the years we've realised the more simple they are, the better they go down in the family. We're gonna start off with Chloe's. For Chloe's one, we've gone with tried and trusted method. Obviously, we're gonna share the Body Shop one. But we've gone, Chloe, when I tell you I traipsed around, I've been to about 7 different supermarkets to find this. Found it in Asda.
Oh, bless you.
We knew that this one was a success.
Oh,
because it's got no caramel in. It's just got chomps, fudges, all the like chocolate that is like plain and Cadbury.
Very happy. A bit early getting it out.
Yeah, because the viewers just need to know what, we know that that one's a good one. So happy with that. Okay, who do I go? This one I got for Samantha, which she might see this video.
She's not here.
I know she's not here, but I'm gonna give it to her. Ferrero Rocher one. That's cool, isn't it?
That is cool.
Yeah, but it's got the coconut one in, and that's a bit rank. But she likes, I checked, she likes the coconut one. For Rob, Dead Lint's his favourite chocolate, so I just went classic for Rob as well. Yeah, classic. Dad, I've gone a bit rogue on you. Hands out and close your eyes. You said you weren't really into chocolate.
What?
Interesting.
Oh, questions.
Just open your eyes.
The Snuffling Pig Company. Is it what I said? It's pork scratchings.
Yeah.
How clever am I?
It's because you said you nice. Liked it. Do
yeah.
you, are you okay with that?
Yeah.
Okay, Oh, Dad. I've never actually seen you eat pork scratchings, though, but you always say that... But I've never seen you tuck into a pork scratching.
I don't get them very often, we never buy
them. You do have two, Mum.
Whoa!
Yeah.
How come I've got two?
Because...
Oh, favourites. I see how it works.
A coffee pod advent is compatible.
Oh, that's fine.
But I don't think it's different flavours. I just think it's bog standard coffee.
Well, is this? It tastes the difference.
Because they have one in Nespresso, but that's about 30 quid. And they actually, in the Nespresso one, you get like decaf coffee and stuff.
Yeah, they don't make it clear. Yeah.
Dad is being naughty. What are you doing?
Look.
That is
like.
So naughty.
Well, you don't know what you're eating, don't you?
Mind you, taste difference is nice coffee.
Salt and vinegar. Well,
and then.
I like this. This is going to be my little.
If Dad's gone in,
evening
my
snack.
Little, not evening, I take this to school.
Are you? Oh, Mum's doing it as well? You're the imposter.
Away somewhere, because I'm going to be very tempted to open this.
Really? You wouldn't. I can't trust people who open their advent calendars like that. Chloe ate her whole advent calendar once, and I never forget
the
that. Because it disgusts me. Oh, they are all... Mum!
What are you doing?
You're breaking it!
Do that.
So Mum's edition is actually quite funny because last year she got really annoyed at this in her advent calendar. So I decided to get the whole thing it. Because you always say you just want a little bit of chocolate in the evening and you'll be fine. So just a little bit of chocolate in the evening. It's just the tiny little balls. How cute is it? And then you can have that with your coffee. Just a singular little ball. Obviously, Dad got me the dairy-free one, which is cracking. Then we've got... So technically, Dad, you have actually... Maybe I give this one to Jesse. Do you reckon he'd like the popcorn one?
No.
You don't think Jesse would like popcorn
one? No, I'd like
Well, you can fight it out between you and Jesse.
No, I think Jesse would like that. I think Jesse and Sarah would like that together.
I've got this guy, the dairy-free popcorn one, and then Chloe, Mum, and I are going to share the Body Shop one. And then this one, I always buy one too many. Never seen that one before.
Oh.
Toblerone.
Toblerone.
I was going to give this to you, Chloe, but it has a dark in it.
Hello.
We'll keep it just in case someone I know doesn't
have
it.
You can have dark ones.
Hello.
Or we find someone who hasn't got an advent calendar.
That's a better idea.
Or I'm really pleased.
Okay, good. Chloe?
Very
I'm really
pleased.
Looking forward to us cracking my lapling.
Good morning. It's day two of lockdown. Sometimes when I say day, then two, my voice doesn't sound like my own. It sounds like a different voice. I have woken up and I've been in bed for a bit longer than I anticipated, just because it feels so weird. I'm going to make myself another to-do list because that actually really helped yesterday. And I nearly got everything done on my to-do list, to be honest with you. It's Friday and I've just got so much to do. I always find Fridays my least favourite days because they're the things in the week that I've been putting off all week that I haven't managed to do. So it's all the things that I don't want to do. So I'm going to... Also, I got some of these like Christmas catalogs in the post, like biscuitiers. I just want to, look how stunning. I'm just going to have a look through these little, and I think I've got a Not on the High Street one as well. So I've done a bit of my work, ticked a few things off, and now I'm getting distracted because I'm looking at all the fun DIY kits available in England during lockdown, because I just think it would be something fun to do. Obviously, you want to try and help small businesses and support the food industry, because obviously be passionate about that. But I think it's such a good idea, all these DIY boxes that you get. Let me know if you want to have a video about that, or maybe if you know any cool DIY kits. Like obviously Donut Time did one. This one's obviously very fancy, but you get a cocktail, wine, the menu, table decoration, a custom playlist. How old is that? But it's only pick up, and that's in London. And I don't live in London, so can't do that, which is annoying, but I'll continue the hunt because there are so many cool people. Are so inventive. I really like adapting. I just feel like so many people have adapted so well and think are thinking innovatively. Oh, this one looks good. Oh, meal kits, this is what I like. Oh wait, I think my sister's eaten from here before and loved it. And dessert and a main for 30 quid. That's quite good. This website has loads of different ones. This is fantastic. Dispatch, it's called Dispatch. They have loads of cool different restaurants that are like taking part. So if maybe you've got a special, like if you've got an anniversary and you'd normally go out for a dinner or something like that, that I'd highly recommend. Well, I've never had them, but from my googling. Guys, look at that. Right, I'm taking things off the list and I have 10 minutes before I need to drop something off to my neighbours. So what I'm gonna do, use this 10 minutes to be productive, and I'm gonna clean my room, otherwise I would just sit on my phone. Who said that? Not me, wasn't me. Yes, I tidied my room, and now I can go on a walk, bypass my neighbours, pick up parcel. Seems like an absolute dream. I think this is actually the comfiest outfit that I've got in my possession. These joggers are so comfy. Thank you, Naina, for introducing me to them. They're the Hollister Super Soft Dad Joggers. I think I've spoken about them before, but they're literally so comfy. Also, I know I look stupid with these headphones, but when I wear my AirPods on my phone, it tells you like your sound levels. And when I wear AirPods, the sound level's really high. Whereas when I wear these, because they're noise cancelling, the sound levels is like low. So I don't want to damage my ears with my AirPods, so I am wearing these. Okay, right, let's get ready to go for a walk, and hopefully by the time I get back, my video will be uploaded. We're going to go to the supermarket. Oh, it's a bit cold. Where did that come from? We're going to go to the supermarket now, get those bits. Explain, but basically my friend had been sad, so I wanted to make her a little, like, pamper bag thing. Package them up nicely, and then she can have a nice little pep in her step goodie bag. I just think it's good to do things for other people. Also, my mum always said whenever I was sad, I'm not sad right now, actually. At the start of lockdown, different story. But now I've just kind of come to terms with it, seizing the day, waking up, trying to get a nice little routine in. But when I was younger, there were like a few steps that my mum used to tell us when we weren't, when we were feeling a bit sad. And one of the things was to do something for someone else. Because you can't really be sad when you're doing something for someone else with the right heart. I think it all comes, wow, it's getting quite deep up in this house. Excuse me. Right, we are here. Also, I just remembered my friend gave me this, how cute, because I've been waking up in the night, which is very unlike me. So I was just started reading it and just had a good read of that. So let's go to Sainos. Oh, I'm loving all the Christmas stuff. Look how cute this is. How adorable. Right, on the hunt for some peanut butter. I'm confused because Marmite already has a strong flavour. So very intriguing. I've managed to pick up the last blueberry muffin. There was no more. And also it was limited edition, so. I can't choose between this and one of these, or maybe and she likes truffles.
Hey, it's haul time, classic. I'm great. Banksy! I just love her so much. Banksy, you don't even know how much I love you. Well, that's just rude. I look after you, I give you tummy tingles when you want them. Anyway, I got this root beer because my dad and my sister love root beer so much. This was £1.75 on offer, and root beer in England is so expensive and it can barely be found. So I'm actually gonna hide this. We have our Christmas cupboard. We've started stashing some bits and bobs up. This is the Christmas cupboard. It's already looking pretty full, but most of it is from me. So I'm gonna put it in there, and then it won't last until Christmas. I know that it won't. But we can keep it for an emergency, and then they might be like, oh, I'm craving root beer, and they'll be like, got just the thing, just the thing. And then for this little box, my friend, I got a few bits. Oh, I also got, my mum said she's really in the mood for ice cream last night, and this chocolate chip cookie dough. I don't really know if it's good or not, but I know my mum's not much of a Ben and Jerry's fan, so I thought we'd try a new one. I don't think I've ever tried this before. Maybe I have, I don't know. Move on to the bits from my friend's box. I know she loves these. They're hot, proper chips, lentil chips. I know, right, she uses this Sanctuary wet shower moisturizer or something. And I know she likes taking baths. So I got her this liquid gold bath elixir. Can you see that? Very fancy. The last blueberry muffin, there still was one left. It didn't even have a little tab at the bottom. Blueberry muffin almond butter, because I reckon she will love this, I think. Hopefully. If she doesn't, then she can just give it back to me because I love it. So, whatever. So, just got this really cute little box of Lindor. And I also got, to be honest, this is just because it's just adorable. Can you see it? Look at how cute it is. It's so little. But I just got home and I've got a parcel, and I think this could be from Donut Time. Oh, I think it is. It might not be, but we'll see. Last week, I sent my friends who did this 24-hour stream, I sent them the kit as like a little congratulations, because I loved it so much last time. And then Donut Time was like, hey, do you want the kit? I was like, wow, full 360 there. Obviously not spawned, they just gifted it to me. So, oh, check out our new vegan DIY kit. It's even got the fizzy sweets, and you know, oh my gosh, and some party sprinkles. Oh no, the blue's leaked. We've sprung a leak. It's donut time. If you want to see us decorate those donuts, check in, subscribe for the next vlog, which will be the next time I post a vlog. So subscribe for that. I love you all. Yes, right, peace.